Your office, 3 o'clock.
Splendid.
Good.
Oh, Harry. Where have you been keeping yourself? I called you a dozen of times, but you never answered.
I would think that you'd finally get the idea that I want nothing to do with you or your propositions. I don't do business with Jews, Gumpel, so stop bothering me. That, I think, was the loneliest moment of my life. When other people hate you, it's unfortunate. But when you hate yourself, it's unbearable. And hurting Max the way I did filled me with self-contempt. Of course, the news that I had publicly insulted him didn't take long to spread. My wife called me at the office and berated me for what I'd done. I went home and tried to mollify her, but it was hopeless. I couldn't tell her why I had to do it. I could only plead rather guiltily for understanding.
All right. You've made your bed, but don't expect me to share it.
Dear Eric, I cannot believe you have changed to this extent. Your outburst this noontime only strengthens my conviction that your conduct has some special hidden purpose. Because I trust you implicitly, I shall consider our friendship only temporarily interrupted. If I can ever be of help, let me know. Every good wish. God bless you. Max.